almost in every note.
A lot of people, if they see someone young doing something at a high level, they consider them a prodigy. But for me, the word prodigy sort of denotes something that's unnatural and something that's sort of slightly forced into being ahead of themselves. So for me, I felt like everything progressed naturally, and so I didn't feel like I was a prodigy at all. I was just playing concerts because I love to perform and because I needed to play concerts to find out more about the pieces that I was working on. I was lucky in being taken seriously and in the way that my musical life has developed, because I had a lot of advice from a lot of people early on, and I was always asking people for advice, so they knew that I was interested in actually having everything work out the best way possible. And everyone told me not to do too many concerts too soon, not to go to management too soon, not to record before I thought I was ready, to stay in school and finish up my studies before really pursuing a full-time concert calendar. So I did all of that, and because of that, I was able to develop in a natural way, musically and personally. I have a lot of friends in Philadelphia because I went to Curtis for 9 years, and so I know people from all different stages of my time at Curtis. Some of my friends have graduated already, some are still students, and I go over to Curtis at times just to sort of see people and walk around and get in touch with the building again. This is the class of 99. There I am. This is the wall, actually this is the hallway where they have all of the pictures of the graduating classes from the very beginning up until that, which is the most recent. There are pictures in black and white. The later pictures are in color. And even have pictures from the 1930s of the first graduating class. This actually is the very first graduating class, and that's the one that has Mr. Brodsky in it. I just found him. There he is. And there's Samuel Barber. And there's Mr. Brodsky's cellist, Orlando Cole, and there are lots of other musicians there. I can't name them all. So that's the very first one which Mr. Brodsky was in, and the very last one which I was in. So it's kind of a nice way to come full circle. And we're even on the same side of the wall, so it all works out perfectly. I have numerous memories of him standing near me, demonstrating something, and I was looking, I'd be looking at a cigarette, and there would be this much ash on it, because he'd forget to tap it in the ashtray. And so, I don't know, this room smelled like smoke for a couple of years after he left, but he was really a great teacher, and for me, this room sort of represents all my years of studying here, because this is where I had each lesson. Thank you. I started working on The Earl King when I was 11. I think I played it for the first time when I was 11 or 12. I think I performed it for the first time when I was 11. And in a way, that might seem like it's young to start a piece like that, because it's a very complex piece. It's tricky. You have to have a lot of extensions, and your hand has to be very, very flexible, and you have to be able to reach things. So I was playing on a full-size violin when I started it. And also, it has everything in the song in this one piece for violin. So you don't have anyone else helping you out with harmonies, or you don't have a clear melodic line that's just going to jump out on its own. You have to actually bring it out. But because I started on it young, actually, that's the first German I learned, because I started learning German when I was 12, but I went through it and wrote in all of the words from the song right where they occurred in the violin part. And so now when I play it, I hear the song in German in my head.
Thank you.